Kenny Guy here on Trib Live. Clint Hurdle has been kind enough to join us all year long. Guy, I kind of had a tear in my eye this morning thinking this was our last live visit with Clint of the season.
I heard he's planning a party for tonight after the game, that he doesn't have to do this again.
It could be true. We'll find out. Clint, is that true? We welcome you back to Trib Live Radio.
I'll have a tear in my eye while I schedule the party.
There you go.
Honestly, we really appreciate your time all year. And we're getting out of the stretch run. I was just curious, from your perspective, you've been through a division race like this. Maybe some of your guys haven't to this level. What's it like seeing the finish line right now? And is there fatigue this time of year? Where does it show up the most, I guess, the fatigue and the pressure of this time of the year?
You know, there's no telling. You'd like to think that the starters would be challenged, you know, just because of the innings, and the rotation has pretty much stayed intact. But I think the way our rotation was put together this year with Charlie, AJ, and Francisco coming to the party a little bit later, giving Locke a blow. Cole has been the one guy who's taken the ball from start to finish and seems to be getting stronger. So, you know, I don't see it there. Bullpen, the volume of work the bullpen's done. I know a lot of people felt we were redlining it early. I think we have kept a very good finger on the pulse and the tempo of the bullpen. These guys have continued to pitch well. For me, it's not about fatigue right now. It continues to be what it's been since opening day, and that's meeting the demands of the game today. And that's what we've got to continue to do. That's where your focus needs to be. It's not who's behind you. It's not really who's in front of you. We have, how many games we've got left now? We've got 6 on the road and 5 at home. We've got 11 ball games to play, but the most important ball game is going to be the one today. We've got to find a way to scratch and claw and get some more offense involved in our game right now as we finish.
Clint, you mentioned Garrett Cole there, and to me, the hardest thing in sports, period, in any sport, is to be consistent. What's impressed me about him is really since the day he came up here, even if he wasn't lights out early in the year, almost, it seems off the top of my head, every time he's gone to the mound, he's at least given you a fighter's chance of winning the ball game. Lately, he's been fairly dominant. I'm just your thoughts on his development, how different he is in September than maybe he was in June.
He is, he's been one of the guys that he's gotten better with each outing. And his focus has been, as our team's has been since opening day, on getting a little bit better today than we were yesterday in some area. Whether it be his fastball command, whether it be the separation his curveball is giving him now in games, whether it be his pickoff move, whether it be his control of the running game times. All these things come into play, and Garrett has stayed focused on taking care of the little things. And his game is in a very good place all over the mound, from the holds, delivery times, fastball command, first pitch strike efficiency. He's shown the ability for swing and miss. He's also shown the ability. The game in Texas retired 11 hitters on 3 pitches or less. So quick contact, good quality pitches down in the zone, off the barrel. It's been fun to watch the development of this young man.
Clint, you had Starling Marte back for about the first time in a month last night. When you played, did you ever have a come back from an injury without a rehab assignment? How difficult is that for a guy to just jump right back in there?
Well, you know, nobody asked me yesterday, and I kept chuckling to myself because they kept asking me if you've ever had a player. No, I've never had a player that had to really just jump back in the game without having a rehab assignment or an instruction league to go get at bats. Hard to believe there was a day, guys, when there were no rehab assignments.
Yeah.
They weren't a part of the game. When I played, they weren't available. You didn't go to AAA. You were on the DL. And then he played. And playing with George Brett, he got banged up a few times. And it seemed like every time he came back, it was an 8-game hitting streak out of the chute. And I think it even got Whitey to say one time the guy could hit line drives with snowballs on Christmas Day. But this is how the game used to be. Marte didn't have the opportunity to go get it back. So, you know, I have been on a DL and had to work in a cage and get some guys to throw live and that, and he was jumping a game and go. I thought Marte had a very consistent and optimistic first game. got a swing off, ran balls down extremely well in the outfield, pushed a bunt, got down the line good. So it's good to have him back in the lineup. I think that bodes well for our offense.
Clint, I was listening to Neil Huntington on his radio show on Sunday talking about the extra scouts that the organization has in the cities that look like they'll be involved in the playoffs. As you go forward, and I know every day is the main thing on your mind is to win the game that day, will there be any point, maybe if you nail down a spot that you can, will you ever consider juggling your rotation to set it up for the postseason, or can you not do that? Do you just have to play out the regular season and then go from there?
You can do whatever you want to do within the realm of guys getting the proper rest to pitch. Now, we're not in that situation right now to juggle. We do have an off day coming up in between the road trip. There's always an option to put a spot starter in. Do you want to give a guy like Compton a start now with our season being where it is when he hasn't started in 12, 13 days? To rearrange your rotation, do you want to wait till the off day after the Chicago series to juggle things? But are you going to try and set up for Cincinnati when pretty much the game tonight's the most important game we got this year, right?
Yep.
And that's the fine line. As we continue to move forward and there's more clarity, and there could be more clarity, I think we'll adjust. Right now, we're set up to go, if we continue in the path we are, Francisco would be available either for the play-in game or the first game wild card game. Obviously, we want to win the division. He would also be available for that if we win the division and you get a couple breaks. So I like the way we're set up right now. We'll just see how it plays out, man.
Pirates manager Clint Hurdle, our guest here on Ken and Guy on Trib Live Radio. After Andrew McCutchen's double in the third, it had a shot of him on second base, kind of imploring the dugout, come on, guys, which is maybe a rare outburst of emotion from Andrew, but I guess the sign of the pressure, the last couple weeks that you're under. How have you liked your leaders and how they've been handling the rest of the team?
Our guys are showing up every day. The leaders lead, and they lead not so much with words, but with actions. And Andrew's second half speaks volume about his continued maturation as a player and as a leader. The last two seasons, the second half has been challenging for Andrew. Being probably the guy in the lineup and teams counterpunching, maybe not pitching him around, maybe pitching more around him than in the past. This year, you look at the numbers. Actually, look at the numbers since the end of April, but especially the numbers in the second half. They all know what's at stake. They're all trying to rally one another. Trying to get everybody moving together with some momentum. And I think from the offensive standpoint, that's the part that the piece we need to get back into play right now sooner than later. And I think that's obviously was Andrew's intent last night. Two quick hits out of the box his first two times up. And unfortunately, as a team, we don't hit a ball out of the infield after the third inning. Other than Andrew's pop foul fly ball. And, the quality of bats, and they're up there trying. They're not trying to make outs. They're not trying to hit weak ground balls, but we've got to have better intent and a commitment level that gets us the results we're looking for.
Clint, the Padres' Andrew Cashner pitched a heck of a ball game the other night against you, and he made the remark that the Pirates are a team that do not hit the curveball well. When someone says something like that, A, does it anger you, or B, do you think there's a ring of truth in that, and is there anything – I mean, it's late in the year now, I know, but I mean, is there anything you could do to improve that?
The truth should never anger you unless, there's something that you haven't done about it. We hit off a curveball machine every day in the cage to recreate a major league curveball. That's about as good as extent you're going to get. And we can tilt it. We can sharpen the angle. We can make it right-handed. We can make it left-handed. If you will dig deeper into that comment, of the 30 major league teams, go check the batting averages of the players on curveballs because you can look them all up. We're one of the teams that has challenges with a curveball. There's a whole bunch of us. I really don't care about the other teams. It has been a pitch that has challenged us, and it's a pitch you've seen. Perfect example, you've seen the development and the dominance of Gerrit Cole. One of the reasons is because he's throwing his curveball now for strikes and for chase. A.J. Burnett's success, the curveball for strikes, makes the fastball quicker. So some pitchers don't have it, which is also a benefit, but the ones that do, when they can play upon the curveball fastball combination. It's real. His comments are truth. And we've just, again, it's another area that we're working hard to get better in. And we've got to find an answer in a real quick period of time.
Pedro got a swipe of a bag last night, his second on the year. Does he have some newfound wheels here after his inside the park home run?
He's running as well as he ever has in a Pirate uniform. He's worked hard on his conditioning, his shape, keeping his weight in play. People still want somebody to grab me and say the amount of errors. And I said, well, if you've watched every game like I have, this man has played the most athletic third base he's ever played this season. There's not a play he can't make. He's got to continue to work hard so some of the other areas don't come his way. It was the first move off a left-hander. Pedro's very astute. He's a good base runner. He shows awareness. And as soon as the Stultz made picked up his foot, Pedro took off, and it made it look easy, didn't he?
He did.
He mentions that home run, that inside to Parker, Clint. And I mean, there's been so many exciting moments this year, but the back-to-back-to-back home runs, which hadn't been done since 1955 at home in Pittsburgh. As I watched when Garrett Jones went back to the dugout, the place was exploding, and you gave him a little tap like he had just hit a sacrifice fly in a spring training game. And I was thinking to myself, he's peeing his pants as he's watching this. He's a lot more excited than he's showing at the moment. Was that true?
Yeah, I'm more excited. I get excited watching our guys be excited. I don't need to jump up and down.
Sure.
I'm jumping up and down inside. And truth be told, I've seen that happen about 12 times. It wasn't the first time. Back in the day when I was a hitting coach for the Blake Street Bombers in Colorado, I think it happened 3 or 4 times 1 year.
Wow.
Love seeing it from our guys. Love seeing the crowd at PNC. Love being in PNC when the crowd erupted like that. We could get a couple more of those little Kodak moments going down the stretch here. That'd be fun to see this weekend.
It would be amazing. Well, Clint, before I let you go, just again, thanks for all the time this year. And
yep.
There was a shot of you guys out and about yesterday on Roberto Clemente Day. And people aren't, I guess, fully aware of how much time away from the yard you put into dealing with the public. And we appreciate your end of it here. And thanks for the whole season of coming on with us.
Well, thank you. No, thank you. It's an honor and a privilege to serve the city of Pittsburgh, our fan base, to spend time in the morning like this. It's a good venue because people do get to get the message from the Pirates out. And you guys ask good questions. So it's a win-win for everybody, and it is an honor to serve. And it's never not a good thing to spread Roberto Clemente's legacy around and continue to help people never forget how great a man he was off the field as well as how great a baseball player he was on the field.
Did we hit 300 in good questions this year?
You did really well, guys. Yeah, good job.
All right, nice. We appreciate it.
Good luck, Clint. We'll be there with you.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Clint Hartle, Pirates manager here on Trib Live Radio. And that's been fun all year. He really has been awesome.
It is amazing to walk into my house and have my mother-in-law ask me, what'd the Reds do? In April, she didn't know who the Reds were.